With all our partners that there are these enrollment centers are accessible to everyone and that they provide as seamless a service as possible so that people can always keep their Aadhaar updated. On the authentication, I think it's important to understand what is the strategic value of this authentication. Now, authentication of identity is done at every point, and broadly authentication of identity is done in three ways. One is what you know, second is what you have, and third is who you are. So let's say that you have some kind of internet email that you use. When you go to access your email, you enter your username and password, and the system therefore assumes that you are the same person because you gave a password. That is an example of authentication using what you know. You know the password or you know the PIN number and so on and so forth. The second type of authentication is authentication with what you have. For example, when you go to an ATM and swipe your ATM card or debit card to withdraw money, in a sense the bank is saying that you're this person because you're in possession of ATM cards. We're all familiar with ATM cards and debit cards. The OTP that you saw essentially is the same concept of authenticating what you have, except that it authenticates a mobile phone, which is your own mobile phone. And this is a very important thing because that OTP is, they showed you, is only valid for 30 minutes, it then disappears, and therefore you can authenticate that the person is in possession of his own phone, and therefore that person is really the person you have. So think of it is very similar to a debit card authentication, except it's authentication a mobile phone. Now why this is important is that authenticating a mobile phone reduces the cost for our partners to really maintain tokens or devices in the hands of their residents or customers. Today what happens is when a bank has say 100 million accounts, then they go and send 100 million debit cards. Those debit cards have to be sent to them, either they have to come to the bank to get the debit card or they receive it by speed post or some kind of registered courier service. They send a separate envelope with the PIN for that debit card. If person loses a debit card, he requests a new thing. So there's a huge, what's called a life cycle management costs for token management for banks and other players. Now, nobody has to manage these tokens anymore because what we're using as a token is already in your possession. You know, we already have, 700-800 million mobile phones out there. So using something that you always carry with you as a way of verifying your identity automatically eliminates the cost of distributing debit cards and all that. So it really makes what you have authentication very simple. Similarly, the who you are authentication that we provide earlier with fingerprint and now with iris is really a new capability that is not there anywhere else in the world. And what this again enables you is to again authenticate a person without sending them anything, because a person comes with themselves, puts the finger or the eye and authenticates. So all these authentication methods, fingerprint based, iris based or OTP based, does not require token distribution. Now the advantage of that strategically is that you can roll it out very quickly. You don't have to get into all these distribution problems. It's very cost effective, it's very rollout. For example, in a PDS system, if you have enrolled 100,000 people, they can immediately start authenticating at a PDS outlet without having to get cards and all that. Similarly, once the DBT, which is being rolled out, will have millions of beneficiaries, they can go to any BC, authenticate and withdraw the money, and you don't have to worry about distributing anything to them cards-wise. So I think the fact that these authentication methods have come is a very important strategic thing in reducing adoption time and making obviously very convenient, as well as in reducing costs. And especially as we advance many of our services to a billion people, being able to do this efficiently at low cost with no distribution of tokens is a very, very important thing, and that's what we hope to accomplish with this authentication services. Similarly, the eKYC service again is something which Ashok talked about in great detail. But I think it's important to again realize the strategic significance of this, because for the first time now you have an online, instant, electronic, paperless way of authenticating a person's proof of identity and proof of address because when you go and authenticate and then you authorize the UIDAI, the UIDAI releases your KYC details electronically in a non-repudiatable, encrypted, signed manner to the other counterparty, which could be a bank or an insurance company. So this really allows you to do an instant KYC, and this has several benefits. The one benefit is that it's instant and so it reduces cost, convenience, and so forth. Second is that it is fully auditable, because since it's a non-repudiatable KYC, tomorrow if somebody wants to audit that this person opened the bank account or this person bought a mobile connection, they just have to look up a digital table and the audit trail will be there, because every KYC has a unique ID, unique transaction code also, which you may not have noticed. So this makes it very simple. One of the big challenges in KYC for banks and mobile companies is, you know, after many years, if you want to audit, how do you go and, you know, review everything? Here, all you need to do is just search a table, it's in the computer. So the auditing also becomes, the traceability becomes very easy. The other benefit of this is that as Aadhaar becomes a KYC for multiple services, then you have one single eKYC architecture that can solve a number of access to services. So I can use my eKYC to open a bank account, I can use the same eKYC to get a mobile connection, same eKYC to get an LPG connection, buy a railway ticket, buy an airline ticket, you know, whatever it could be. So get my PDS. So once you sort of have the eKYC as a common KYC across product categories, it simplifies things a lot. So you could have one device which does all these things. So you could have potentially, let's say there's a outlet which is a citizen service center or a grocery store or a oil pump or Anganwadi worker. If they have one electronic device, that outlet can open a bank account or give a mobile connection or sell an insurance policy or provide PDS, all using the same architecture. And the advantage of that is that that outlet then becomes a single sort of gateway to a lot of services anywhere in the country, which we can offer very, very easily. So the ability to diffuse services becomes very, very quick. The second benefit of this architecture is that it has a huge network effect. Because let's say that there are 300 million people on the system who have an online Aadhaar ID, and let's say some service provider, let's say the insurance regulator allows or launches an insurance policy which can be provided online using Aadhaar, then instantly all 300 million people who have the number become eligible to get access to that product. So you get the network effect very quickly with this. So I think these are all very strategic things, and we really look forward to working with our partners, because our goal now in the next 6 months is to accelerate on one side enrollment, another side DBT, on the third side authentication services, and then finally use the eKYC to make sure that people have access to services in a wide way. So I think what this is all bringing out is the long-term platform benefits of the Aadhaar platform, because now the Aadhaar platform can be used as a gateway to electronic services using eKYC. The Aadhaar authentication can be used as a transaction provider so that you can use it to withdraw money from your bank account or get rice or wheat from your PDS system. So the first benefit is as a gateway to services, and the second benefit is as a transaction authentication for your money or any other things that you need to get. And there's a third benefit which we shall start accruing in a few years, which is that you can also use it as a way to have portable digital assets. What I mean by that is that, let's say that you have your electronic health record somewhere on the cloud, then when you go into a hospital for a checkup, you can authorize this electronic health record system to release your health records to the hospital so that they give you better treatment. It'll have your previous history, it'll have your details of any allergies you have, and so forth. So you can create portable digital assets. It could be your electronic health records, it could be your electronic credit records, it could be your electronic skill and degree records. So basically you can create these electronic portable digital assets which you can attach to your Aadhaar number, and then wherever you go you can carry your assets with you and then authorize them using Aadhaar or eKYC. So I think this platform is now going to start seeing a lot of benefits, so we look forward in the coming years to have our partners build, and these are going to be built by our partners. So we look forward to all our partners building more and more very exciting services that benefit the people of India. Thank you very much.